Okay, dear students, now we are going to discuss a plant breeding for the development of a disease resistant varieties in crop plants. So plant breeding for disease resistance. So given heading is plant breeding for disease resistance. For the development of a disease resistance okay. So before going into various methods by means of which we can produce a hybrid varieties, we should know what are the diseases caused by and what are the organisms which are able to cause diseases in crop plants. So definitely various microbes. So microbes such as bacteria, fungi, and viruses, particularly these microbes are causative agents, pathogens of a number of plant diseases. These are the causative agents able to cause a particular disease. Okay, so here crop losses because of bacterial, fungal, viral diseases is up to 20% to according to textbook 30% damage or crop loss, damage to the crop, or sometime complete failure also, complete devastation also, complete famine. It leads to complete famine. Okay, right? So to avoid these diseases, what about synthetic fertilizers? So to control various bacterial viral diseases, we have been using bactericides and fungicides. So here bactericides and fungicides are synthetic fungicides. They are not eco-friendly. They enter into food chain. They cause pollution. Okay, soil pollution. And they enter into food chain, ultimately entering into our body also. That is harmful to entire ecosystem. So we have to avoid bactericides and fungicides. So for that one, to avoid so-called bactericides and fungicides, we have to development of disease resistant varieties is mandatory to use to curtail uses of bactericides and fungicides. Okay, right? So here, what are the examples of plant diseases caused by bacteria, fungi, and viruses? Certain number of examples. So what are the fungal diseases in your textbook? Certain number of fungal diseases given. What are they? What are the fungal diseases? Few examples. Okay. So one is a first fungal disease. That is a wheat rust. Wheat rust is well known to you. Wheat rust caused by pathogen is a Puccinia. Puccinia species, rust fungus. Ascomycetes, go back to fungi, you'll get it. Wheat rust. Next, red rot of sugar cane, red rot. Internal tissue in which sucrose present is converted to red colored one. That is caused by colletotrichum. Colletotrichum falciatum, a fungus, Deuteromyces fungus. Next, late blight of a potato. Late blight of a potato caused by Phytophthora species. So these are a certain number of fungal diseases. And what about a certain number of bacteria? So many are there. Some I am giving you from your textbook. Bacterial disease. Moreover, you studied a number of bacterial and viral diseases under the heading microbiology. Okay. So given one is a black rot of cruciferous. Black rot of cruciferous, citrus canker. So many diseases are there. And what about other diseases, viral diseases? Viral disease, tobacco, mosaic, viral disease, tobacco, mosaic. Turnip mosaic. Okay, so these are a certain number of diseases caused by fungi, bacteria, viral concern. Okay, so there is a need to provide a resistance against these bacteria, fungi, and virus. So resistance against these fungi depends on genetic constitution of any organism, not only plants. Nowadays we are facing COVID-19. If our immunity is very strong or strengthened, definitely we can get victory over COVID-19. So here in our body, immunity against our antibody production against the virus is COVID-19 is very less, definitely will be succumbed to death. Just or not? So ultimately, disease resistance depends on our genetic material. Okay, so we have to manipulate the genetic material. By manipulating the genetic material, definitely we can introduce or we can create a desirable gene in the hybrid variety by means of which that hybrid is able to withstand so-called diseases. So what are the plant breeding methods required we are adopting to produce a disease resistant varieties? So before a plant breeding is to be taken or before operation of that one, we should know certain number of facts about pathogens. What is the type of the pathogen? Means causative agent or organism. And what about mode of transmission? Mode of transmission also important. And other characteristics of that pathogen. So what are the methods we are following to produce a disease resistant varieties? One of them is We'll discuss one by one. First one is a classical breeding method or traditional breeding method, that is artificial hybridation. Already we studied artificial hybridation. Selection of parents, artificial xenogamous type of cross-pollination, and before that one, emasculation, bagging, and selection of hybrid varieties recommended for cultivation. It also same method. So here, we have to select a wild parent in which disease-resistant genes are present. If they are available, we can transfer that gene into one variety. So by means of artificial hybridation, it is not easy to introduce, impossible, not easy, impossible to introduce a gene which is not existing in the concerned crop. If it is available, we can transfer. Okay, so what are the disease-resistant varieties we developed in the case of bacteria, fungi, and viruses? What are the examples? So disease-resistant varieties developed by artificial hybridization. So development of disease-resistant varieties by means of artificial hybridization. So disease-resistant varieties by hybridization, artificial hybridization. What are the examples or varieties we developed by means of hybridization? So these are also achievements of artificial hybridization. What are they? Certain number of examples given in our textbook. What are they? Wait, hang on, please. What are they? First one is a wheat variety, crop. What's the type of crop? Some examples. You have to memorize all these things. Not easy. Okay. Crop name. What about the crop name? And variety developed, hybrid variety. Variety developed by this method. And resistant to. Okay. So this so-called column is very, very important. This box is very, very important. So first given one is, first example is a wheat crop. Wheat. The scientific name of wheat is well known to you. Do you know? Go back to living world classification. Triticum aestivum. Triticum. Triticum aestivum. And a variety is a Himagiri variety. The variety name is a Himagiri. Himagiri, Konda. Himagiri variety. So that is a resistant to what type of diseases? Fungal diseases, leaf. They are fungal diseases. Leaf and a stripe rust. Leaf rust and stripe rust. You should remember all these things. And hill bunt also. Hill bunt. Fungal disease. So Himagiri variety was produced by artificial hybridization. Okay, next brassica. Mustard. Avalu. Mustard, avalu. brassica, mustard. The variety is a Pusa Savarnim. Savarnim, Pusa Savarnim, Karan Roy. I think this one is a Hindi word, I think. Karan Roy. So this variety was developed against the wheat rust. Okay, black rot. Okay, and one more thing here, wheat rust. Okay, black rot of cruciferous. Black rot of cruciferous. Cruciferae, Brassicaceae family. Once upon a time, they called Brassicaceae as a cruciferae, caused by bacteria. Okay, next, cauliflower. Okay, so what about the scientific name of cauliflower? Brassica Wallaracea. Variety Brassica Wallaracea, variety Botrytis. See, mustard, cauliflower. What about the scientific name, generic name of cauliflower and mustard, same or not? Notice it. They belongs to same genus, Cruciferae family. Okay, so what are the varieties? Varieties given. Pusa Superba. Subra. Pusa. Pusa Subra. Pusa Snowball. Snowball. K1. Okay, against Carl Blight. Curl blight, black rot. Okay. Next, cowpea. What about cowpea? This is well known to you. Cowpea is the scientific name of this one is Vigna Unguiculata. Vigna Unguiculata. That is a white colored bobberlu. Do you know bobberlu? Bobberlu. Generally, we cook and use that one as a food for cattle. Vigna Unguiculata. Okay, so what about a variety? Pusa Komal. Variety is a Pusa Komal. Pusa is the habitat, botanical ornamentation where we developed all these. Pusa Komal. It's very hard to memorize all these things. Pusa Komal. Black blight. And last one, chili capsicum. Solanaceae family member. Chili. And the variety is Pusa Sadabahar. Pusa sada bahar. So resistant to chili mosaic virus, tobacco mosaic virus. Chili mosaic. Okay. And against tobacco mosaic virus also. Okay. Leaf curl also, one more. Leaf curling. Viral diseases. Try to memorize all these things. Okay. Next, abelmascus, lady's finger. Abelmascus. Esculentus. Lady's finger. Example, Farbani. Kranti. Variety. That is against yellow mosaic virus. Yellow mosaic virus. So please try to memorize all these examples. Okay, right? And we have to discuss what about Farbani Kranti variety. Okay, is it clear? Wait, hang on. So now I'm taking what about the development of a Farbani Kranti variety. So what about the development of a Farbani Kranti variety? So Kranti Bendy variety, lady's finger variety. Okay. Okay, so abelmascus. Abelmascus. Esculentus. Okay, so this one is a high yielding one. High yielding one. So high yielding means desirable character, undesirable character, susceptible means affected by, not resistant, weak, susceptible to yellow mosaic disease. Okay, crossed with a wild variety, that is a abelmascus manyheartland. Okay, same genus, different species, Esculentus manyheartland. What about the drawbacks of this one? Limitations. Low yield. Agronomically undesirable. But it is resistant to yellow mosaic virus. So out of this variety and this variety, this is a hybrid variety. This is a wild variety. Desirable characteristics. High yielding, desirable. This one resistant to yellow mosaic virus. So cross between these two. So this cross is a, this one is intra generic are inter specific cross. Okay, so variety producers are Parbani, Kranti, variety with a high yielding coming from Esculentus and are resistant to yellow mosaic virus from its wild variety. Okay, so this is a product of artificial hybridation only. Okay, is it clear? And it is an intra-generic cross, inter-specific cross. So these are the achievements of disease-resistant plants by means of artificial hybridation. Okay, is it clear? Next, last one, last but one, I think, mutation breeding. Second one, mutation breeding, development of a disease-resistant varieties by mutations, mutation breeding. Okay, so what is mutation? Sudden heritable change in the genotype of an organism is called as a mutation. So by means of mutations, concerned plant breeder is able to change nucleotide sequence present in the genetic material. By changing sequence of nucleotides present in a DNA or RNA, definitely we can develop a gene, new gene, which is not existing in that crop variety. By means of artificial hybridation, there is no chance for development and creation and introduction of a desirable gene which is not existing in that population. But by means of mutation breeding, we are able to develop a gene which is not existing in that population. For example, A is the parent. A is a parent. Okay. So in this parent, X gene, whatever the gene, is not existing in that parent. Now it is subjected to mutations. After subjecting it to mutations, now A plant is with A, some plant, whatever it is, with X gene. X is a dummy one. X gene, which is not existing in that population. So creation of a new gene is possible by means of a mutation breeding. So we can use this one for cultivation, or we can use it as source parent means source of that X gene in plant breeding. Use it as a source parent in hybridization, artificial hybridization. This statement you can't understand from the textbook. A is a normal variety, B convert into A with X gene. So mutant variety produced by means of mutations. So now A variety is with X gene. recommend for cultivation if it is desirable, or use it as a parent in artificial hybridization to transfer that gene into some other plant. Okay, right? So mutations are two types: spontaneous mutations. Spontaneous means natural, by means of natural factors. Second one, induced mutations. Here I'm taking second type. So mutations are types of mutations. One, natural mutations. Natural mutations, rarely possible, leave it. Come to second one, induced mutations. Induced mutations means artificial. We are inducing mutations. To induce mutations, chemicals are required. So chemicals are agents. Better take agents. Agents used in mutations are called as mutagens. What is a mutagen? A compound, agent, a chemical, a physical factor which is able to cause mutations. So what are the types of mutagens? What are they? One, chemical mutagens, chemical mutagens, chemical mutagens. So what are the chemical mutagens, chemical mutagens? For example, certain number of alkaloids, colchicine. Go back to Liliaceae, colchicine, alkaloid. Next, physical mutagens. Physical mutagens. What are they? Examples. X-rays. X-rays. Gamma rays given in your textbook. Gamma rays, UV rays also, ultraviolet rays also, UV rays also. Okay, generally we should not take so many X-ray films, MRIs, CT scans. Reason, what about that radiation that is a physical compound, rays? That a physical factor is able to change nucleotide sequence present in our body. So that leads to what? Mutation. Okay. So these are the examples for mutagens. Actually, most of the mutations are harmful to the individual, lethal to the individual. Only some are useful. So in your textbook, the given example is, one example is given. The example variety is mutant variety, that is a mung bean. What is mung bean? Mung bean is green gram, pesalu, green gram. Do you know Haldiram mung bean? That is a, what we call that one? Moong dal. Very good. Good boy. Moong dal. Green gram. So this one is resistant to yellow mosaic viral disease. It's a viral disease. Next one is powdery mildews. Powdery mildews. That is a fungal disease. fungal disease. So we developed a mung bean variety, which is resistant to yellow mosaic virus, powdery mildews. Yellow mosaic, viral disease. Powdery mildews, fungal disease. Okay, so that is about mutation breeding. So here, this statement is very, very important. For example, this is a mutant variety. Recommend for cultivation or use that one as a parent, source of that X gene to transfer that one into hybrid variety during artificial hybridization. Okay, is it clear? So that is about plant breeding for disease resistant varieties. And last one, third one, soma clonal variants means hybrid varieties developed by tissue culture actually. So what about the soma clonal variant? So somatic tissue, take a somatic tissue of a plant, whatever the plant, transfer on to the culture medium. Culture medium, food. Culture medium is nothing but food, nutrient medium, artificial food. So if it is cultured on the culture medium, definitely soma clone produce. So what is the soma? Soma means somatic tissue. Okay, so this progeny is produced from somatic tissue. Somatic tissue or not? Soma, vegetative body. Clone. Clone means genetically homogeneous population coming from single parent. As this clone is coming from somatic tissue, it is called as a soma clone. So in this soma clone, all are of one kind only. So 100% all are similar. Now, what is a soma clonal variant? Now, this soma clonal variant is subjected to mutation, either naturally or artificially. If it is subjected to mutation, definitely variation is possible or not? So variety developed is called as a soma clonal variety. That's it. Okay, so simply development of a variety from the somatic tissue is called as a soma clonal variant. So this is by means of tissue culture. We have to use tissue culture. Okay. So far we completed development of disease resistant varieties by means of artificial hybridization, mutation breeding, and soma clones also. Soma cloning is one type of mutation breeding, but we are using tissue culture. Okay. Bye. See you. We will meet tomorrow. And the tomorrow topic is development of resistant varieties against the pest and insect. Okay. We will see that one tomorrow. Okay. Bye. See you. We'll meet again. Bye. See you.